Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to Hypermind Modded. Today, we are going to be working on a system for automated emeralds. That's right. You ready? Let's get started. You heard it correctly, ladies and gentlemen. We've got automated, well, we've got the quarry we can run every now and then. That gives us plenty of materials otherwise. But the one thing that we tend to run into is emeralds. We don't have an automated way of producing those. So we've got to find a way. And before we get into that, I need to show you a little bit of work that's been done around the castle. So not much. You can see that we've still got the wool barriers up all around, showcasing where buildings should be going. But I have taken one down. We've put in a stable. So here we go. I've pulled the horses and donkeys, or well, just one horse. Pulled the horse and the donkeys out of the golden lassos. They said they were getting kind of cramped in there, so I figured I'd let them out. So I gave them a little bit more room. So we've got not much in the way of decoration. A little bit of hay there and got some water in cauldrons for them. But overall, nothing too fancy. Again, it's the stables, but it's right here by the main entrance. And so maybe we'll do one on the other side as well, so we can have stables on both sides. But there we go. So let me know what you think. I'd love to hear from you about what you're thinking there. Maybe we take that off. Can we get in now? Okay, so if I've got the boots on, I can't go in. But if I've got the boots off, I can. So the high step does not work. Or rather, it works in about the same way as the horse and donkey AI does. So you notice I don't have any barriers here. The donkey thinks that it doesn't have enough room to get out of the stable here. As my phone goes off, I really need to turn those off. So let's just take care of that. Unprofessional, to be sure. So the donkey thinks that he can't get out, even though there's enough room for him to. But, you know, is he going to let me off? Or let me? No, he won't. Yeah, they don't like me. So yeah. Maybe the step up is doing the same thing as the donkey AI. But that's not what we're here for. We're here to do something over in this section right here. So I've got this little building right here. It's a tower. It's supposed to be a guard tower, but we're going to put something that's rather disturbing, actually. It's a feature of Tinker's Construct. I'm not sure if you guys know about it. Some of you might. But you can actually smelt villagers into emeralds. Again, it's very disturbing. So the way we're going to do that is with a smeltery. And if you have been watching, hopefully by now, I have put this on the channel. But I've got a little tutorial for how to set up a basic smelter. And we're going to be building one. It's not quite the same as what I had originally done. And we don't need those in our inventory. We need the rest of this. One more thing. We need seared faucet. All right, so we're going to build a smeltery right here. A little bit more advanced than the one in the tutorial. But you can see, hopefully, a card showing up on your screen, or has already shown up on the screen and then gone away by now, for that tutorial, if you would like some more information about that. We're going to build a 3-high smeltery. This will make sure that we can take care of all the villagers that we throw in here. Again, it's kind of morbid if you really think about it. No, you can't go there. We got to put you right here. And then we'll get some more seared brick. We'll put that there. And then here on the front, we will do the controller, a drain and a drain. And then we'll come up here and just fill this in with some more seared brick, just to make sure we've got plenty of smeltery to go around. So we'll put our seared faucets on like so. And then the casting basin like so. And then to make sure that we always have lava, and it looks like we might be having some issues. We might have to go check on our lava production over in the Nether. And I might have turned that off. I'm not sure. So that's going to be the smeltery. We're going to put that right in the middle. And then let's take a look at the rest of our supplies. We've got an MFR auto spawner. We're going to be using that. We've got Safari Net. That's got a villager in it. I'm not sure which villager. And then we've got Ender Chest. We'll need that. We need all the laboratory blocks. Plenty of tesseracts to go around. Quite clear glass. And what else? I'm going to need those to make them go faster. Some mob essence. That should be good for now. What I'm going to do is build a little area like this. We're going to bring in the laboratory blocks to just kind of add some decoration. And that gets me to the smeltery controller. Yep, so we're going to do this. And then I'm going to build a little platform. And we can set up the MFR auto spawner once we get this whole thing set up. And that's going to give us the maximum spawning area. And then we can put our conveyor belts in and still make sure we get plenty of villagers coming into our system here. So I'm going to finish this part out and then I'll bring you back when it's time to put in the auto spawner. I realize that I have not shown you where I'm getting all the lava for this thing. So let's go to the Nether. I've got an area here in my Charma dislocation that's set up for it. Let's see. And I kind of have to be careful around here. It should be. Okay, so it is. Okay, that thing's running. So I don't know what's up with how it looks over here. So something might be off slightly. That's fine. It is time to put in the auto spawner though. So let's go take care of that as we get some chunk rendering issues here. We're going to put that like so. We want to make sure we have plenty of room for this thing. So we'll just pop it right there. And hopefully that is... No, you know what? I think we need to make it go up one. And will that come in? Okay, yep. So my magnet is working. Let's try putting that on, and we will turn that to the on place. Okay, so is this thing getting full? Yes, it's getting full, and there's nothing in there. We're not going to put the item in there quite yet because I'm not quite ready. But what we need to do is grab those pieces, and then we will put our tesseract up here. And we'll set that. It's on the personal network. We're going to do nothing with items or fluids. So do far and receive energy. We're going to get that from the Power Plus network. So there we go. Should have plenty of power. We've got plenty of essence. We're going to say no spawn on the exact copy. And then what we need to do is put something in here just to get things started. I had some, what is this? There we go. We'll put some iron into here to get going. And there we go. All right. So the reason we have to do that is that we have to add a little bit of damage possibility to our villager friends. And then what we're going to do is cap this off. And do I have any more? Yes, I have more. I just placed that in the wrong spot. All right. And what we're going to do is just make sure that this thing is spawning. We'll try one like so. Is that going to go? It should be working. Let's see. Yep. Okay. So we'll see once the iron goes in how things look for these guys. It's going to sound pretty bad, but we'll just let them go for now. And then we'll turn this thing back on once we have our automatic system in place for getting the emeralds out. How long is that iron going to be taking? Okay, it's almost done. So we'll get a little bit of iron in here. See once that goes, okay. Yep. All right, so now those guys are taking damage. And then, yep, there we go. And we should have a little bit of emerald in there. 0.75 emeralds. All right, so we're gonna have to run that for a while. So what I'm gonna do is, I've realized this is not tall enough, and we wanna maybe bring the tesseract up so we can turn this whole machine off. So let me take care of a little bit more of that infrastructure, and I'll come back and we'll take a look at the clock mechanism. All right. Well, I've just had a change in plans. I was going to try a complicated clock with some comparators all feeding into each other, and then I realized, you know what, that's very vanilla. So what can we do in modded for the problem that we've got here? So what we need to do is we need to leave a little bit of liquid in here. I do need to maybe pull this molten iron out. We might do that a little bit later. I'll do that off camera. So we'll get that molten iron out. And what we need to do is leave enough liquefied emerald in here that the system keeps running itself. Okay. And then we need to take enough out to put into this casting basin. And then we need all of those emeralds, those lovely emeralds, to go back into our ME system. All right. What do you think we should do in that case? I'll give you just a little bit before I tell you what we are going to be doing. You guessed? Hopefully so. We are going to be using Steve's Factory Manager. That's right. So we're going to put that here. And then what we will do is put, oh, this thing also, we're going to put a vacuum chest, because I noted that sometimes items come out of the villagers when they meet their demise. So what we're going to do is to get some inventory cable. Can we do that? Let's see if we can. Maybe I should have planned this a little bit better. Let's go get some inventory cable and see if we can take care of what it is we need to take care of. We've got a crafting area here. I could have just checked my wireless. Oh, we do have some inventory cable. Plenty of inventory cable. Okay, so let's go take care of that. We'll drop that into our system here. So, yep, we're pretty much just using Steve's Factory Manager for everything. All right, so we're going to do that. And then what we will do is put our ME Ender Chest right there. We can do that because this Ender Chest will open even if there's a solid block above. And then what we're going to do is put a little chest right here. All right, so first things first, we're gonna need some what are we gonna do? You know what, I am gonna take care of some of this off camera, and then I'll bring you back once we've got this all put together, because I'm gonna be clicking around and I don't know if you want to see all that. So I will be back in just a moment. All right, so I had to turn that thing off just while I'm recording because it is rather noisy, but let's take a look at what we've got. So we've got our Steve's Factory Manager right here. Got a couple inventory cables. I showed you that already. The new thing here is a vacuum chest, and that's because some of those villagers will drop gold coins as well. I have those currently stuck in there just so you can see the process, and we're going to change this to insert, and there we go. So that should be able to grab anything that the villagers drop. Hopefully, we shall see long term. I've even thought about pulling this back out. And do I grab any more? No. How about on the far side here? Nothing. Okay, so we'll just leave the smeltery like that with no columns. And then let's take a look at the manager right here. Oh, and we're back. Sometimes that happens when I click the inventory manager with a tool. All right, so we should be good. So what I've got here is per usual, we've got some variables here. I've got one for the output that's going to go to that inner chest. The accumulator is the regular chest, casting basin, and the smeltery. So we've got a trigger. It's going to check every 1 second. We're going to split it up. I haven't turned on any of these, so we'll turn that on in just a moment. But let's take a look at this condition. It's a liquid condition. We're going to check the smeltery drain and see if it's got at least 2 buckets of liquefied emerald. If it does, we're going to pull from the smeltery drain, again using the variables, just in case I need to move this thing. It will make moving it a lot easier. So we're going to grab 1 bucket. Let's go back here, right click, there we go, 1 bucket. We're going to grab that. And then here's the thing. I was having some issues with both the condition and the input. Let's take a look. We have to make sure that we're grabbing the inventory from the correct direction. Okay, so our inventory manager is this way. The drain is facing into the inventory manager. So let's take a look at our F3 screen. Notice I'm going to try and bring the cursor up here so you can see up here where it says F:1. That's the west direction. So we have to make sure that we're pulling items from the west direction. So let's take a look. So I've got here, it's currently activated. Everything else is deactivated. And we have to make sure that we pull that from the same spot as well. So there we go. We've got the west direction pulled. And then the output is going to be into the up direction. So the inventory manager is on the top. So we're putting the liquid in from the top. And then once again, variable. All right. Then what we do is we've got a condition on the casting basin. This time is an item, and we're going to be looking specifically for a block of emerald. Again, grabbing it from the top. If we've got one, pull it from the same spot, casting basin, and then we will put that into our accumulator chest for a little bit extra processing. So let's do that. And we should see once we come over here that we've got a block of emerald, and you see that this thing is already filling up. How much do we have in here? We don't have much. It's not going to fill up the rest of the way. So yeah, let's take a look at this last condition. It's not really a conditional. What we're going to do is grab every block of emerald from the accumulator right there, and then we're going to send that into a crafting grid like so, and we're going to get the regular emeralds out. Nothing special there. We're just going to send this into the output chest. And before I hook that up, let's just take a look in our wireless terminal here at not gravel, emerald. All right, so we've got 182, right? That's what I'm reading. Let's hook this up, and we should see fairly soon that we've got, 191? Yep, there we go. All right, so this thing is going to be producing emeralds as long as we've got mob essence, and that mob essence is coming into the ender tank system through our ME system. Let's come over here. I should just be walking because I've got those step-up boots. So let's take a look in here and look in our fluid terminal. So we've got 19 kilobytes of mob essence. That's all coming from our spawner over in the spawner area. And what we're doing is we're exporting it right here to the ender tank network. So you can see that right there. That's exporting mob essence. So that's how we've got that going. So now we've got something that is going to be using the mob essence and producing more materials. So yeah, that's kind of the whole point of this base, is to keep moving these automated structures around. So I hope that this thing can keep up. It should be. Yeah, it should be able to keep up. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is how to make automated emeralds, once again using Steve's Factory Manager, which is kind of cool. So I was originally thinking something rather convoluted, but Steve's Factory Manager makes it very simple indeed. Let's take a sleep, and then we'll need to get that screenshot as well. But I want to say, if you've been inspired for this, a like is always appreciated, and I'd love for you to share your screenshots of things that you've come up with, maybe not necessarily in modded, but even in vanilla as well. I'd love to see them. You can hit me up on Twitter at MCSoapTheGreat. And hey, if you haven't done so already, think about subscribing. Doesn't cost you a dime, and make sure that you are up to date with what's going on in the channel. That's rather imposing right there. Let's take that off. And as always, thank you so much for spending a little bit of your time today with me. It means a lot, and I hope you have enjoyed. And I will see you next time. Bye-bye.